Problems are inevitable in marriage.
Les problèmes sont inévitables dans le foyer.
There's no marriage that is a perfect one.
Il n'y a pas de mariage parfait.
But when there are problems, we must identify them and resolve them.
Néanmoins, s'il y a des problèmes, nous devons les identifier et aider à les résoudre.
Usually when there is a sign or when there are signs that the foxes are destroying the vineyard, people have different responses, right? They have different responses. When they identify that there is a sign, there are signs coming.
Et aussi quand les renards sont en train de ravager les vignes, les gens réagissent différemment.
The first response, the preferred response to many people.
Et la première réaction ou bien réponse.
That we will divorce.
On va.
I will divorce you.
Je vais te divorcer.
And they'll say it once.
La personne va dire ça une fois.
Two.
Deuxième fois.
By the third time.
Et la troisième fois.
They are in the world.
La personne est partie.
But the threat of divorce is an immature way of responding to marriage challenges.
Mais j'aimerais vous dire que c'est une manière immature de réagir dans vos mariages quand il y a des problèmes.
Divorce is an escape from reality.
Le divorce est
an escape from reality.
Un moyen d'échapper à la réalité.
It is a way of immaturity.
Et ça démontre l'immaturité.
And weakness.
Et faiblesse.
I would say it is an expression of wickedness in people's heart.
Et ça démontre la méchanceté qui est dans le cœur de la personne.
But do we have to wait until there is a red light?
Devons-nous attendre jusqu'à ce que le feu rouge?
Should men wait until there is a red light? Should women wait until there is a red light?
Les hommes ou bien les femmes doivent attendre jusqu'à ce que le feu rouge s'allume?
In America was that policeman?
En Amérique, il y avait ce policier qui a tué un Africain.
While he kneels on the neck of that young man,
quand il s'est agenouillé sur le cou de monsieur,
he was shouting.
Le jeune homme
please,
priait.
Please.
Il demandait pardon.
I am dying.
Je suis en train de mourir. Je n'arrive pas à respirer.
I'm dying.
Je suis en train de mourir.
The voice faints. At the end, you could not hear him but say, ma.
Et finalement, tu ne peux pas l'entendre.
An adult does not cry, mama, right?
Parler, mais il disait seulement, mama, mama. Et un adulte n'appelle jamais sa maman.
There are children who call mommy.
Et ce sont les enfants qui appellent leur maman quand ils sont en danger.
But that wicked police had waited. Have seen
néanmoins, ce
the green light, the
policier,
yellow light of
il a
death.
Vu le feu vert, le feu jaune de la mort.
And waited until there is the red light and that young man died. In the marriages, there are signs
donc,
that
the mariage,
man and a woman
des signes
could see.
Que l'homme ou bien la femme peut voir.
If you are blind and you do not see it, another person will see it and tell you these are foxes. You got to catch it.
Même si
let us catch them for you.
Aveugle et tu ne peux pas voir, il y a d'autres personnes qui peuvent voir et ils vont attirer ton attention.
Many men on this on this earth undermines complaints of women. You see, when your wife begins to complain, one, he begins to complain, two, she begins to complain, three, and continue to complain about one thing, continue to complain one thing, you have to halt and check what is happening there.
Beaucoup d'hommes ignorent les plaintes de leurs femmes.
What is happening there? If you ignore it,
si vous ignorez,
very soon the red light will come.
Ces choses, le feu rouge va s'allumer.
And it takes only the grace of God.
Et ça va prendre la grâce de Dieu.
Oh, but for the sake of Jesus Christ.
Mais à cause de Jésus-Christ.
May there be peace.
Que la paix règne.
In all relationships.
Dans vos foyers.
There are many ladies who ignore the complaint, the cry of their husband. You could hear this young man say continuously, stop it, I don't like it, stop it, this one is not good, don't do this one. But there are ladies also who continuously, persistently ignore.
Et aussi, il y a des femmes qui ignorent les cris de leur mari.
Until there is a red light.
Jusqu'à ce que le feu rouge.
I charge you this morning, do not wait until there is a red light in your marriage.
Un défi, n'attendez pas jusqu'à ce que le feu rouge.
Halt your activities and pay attention to your wife, to your husband.
Fais attention.
Because if you do not do that,
à ta femme,
you
ou bien à ton mari,
will destroy that beautiful family.
Sinon, tu vas détruire ta vie.
And you will destroy other people.
Et d'autres s'y seront détruits.
There is a second response that people give.
Il y a une deuxième réaction.
I call it marriage speech. Marriage speech.
Et j'appelle ça
speech. Yeah, speech. Discours.
Mariage.
I was studying a course some years ago in a university called public speaking. How you must speak when you stand in front of people, right?
J'ai étudié une matière à l'université qui
public speaking.
Qui nous montre comment parler en public.
And the professor said that.
Et le professeur disait.
It is an art of preparing.
Et c'est un art.
Staging
moyen de préparer
and delivering deliberately a speech in a way that can attract people's attention.
Et c'est un art de préparer un discours qui peut attirer
a staging, like play.
Les spectateurs.
That is not how you speak. That is not you. But because of people, the audience, you want to you hold your mic in a certain way, your voice pitch, you want to change in a certain way, your look, your actions, you want to do everything in a way to attract attention.
Et il disait que tout ce que tu vas faire devant le public, tu dois faire ça pour les attirer, pour avoir d'influence.
There are some people in their marriages, their response to the foxes is an act of public speech. They act a concert so that a man and a woman may sit down. They are fighting and about to kill one another, but you see them, they are when they see you. Oh, chéri Coco.
Et tout ce que l'apôtre aimerait dire que parfois, quand il y a des problèmes dans le foyer, les couples prétendent et ils jouent au concert. En public, ils prétendent être ensemble, mais à la maison, ils sont comme le chien et le chat.
The wife will say there is nothing wrong, everything is well with us, and the woman will say oh no, everything is correct.
Et quand tu demandes au monsieur, va dire oh tout va bien, et la dame aussi tout va bien, ils vont sourire, mais à la maison, c'est seulement Dieu qui sait ce qui se passe.
No one can get inside.
Et si ça n'est ainsi, c'est difficile d'aider.
Solomon. And his lover says that, catch for us the little foxes.
Néanmoins, Solomon disait, prenez-nous les renards, les petits renards qui ravagent les vignes.
The third response, which I recommend to you, is godly advice. never undermine the counsel of your pastor or pastor's wife. Never in your life.
À la légère, les conseils que vos pères ou bien vos mères spirituelles vous donnent.
Sometimes many years before you realize it's too late. They are there for you.
Ils sont là pour vous.
The third response is that people seek godly counseling with the intention of building the marriage. There is no marriage without problem. Hello?
Tout mariage a des problèmes.
Yeah. So when there is problem, you need to seek godly counsel.
Donc,
and when you have been given a godly counsel, you must listen.
Donc quand il y a des problèmes, vous devez demander conseil auprès de vos pères ou bien vos mères spirituelles.
So let's be very careful. We don't break our covenant. Don't allow foxes to eat into your vine until that beautiful covenant is broken.
Donc, faut pas laisser les renards ravager vos vignes, parce que Dieu haït le divorce.
Malachi chapter 2, the verse 15 to 16. Malachi 2, 15 to 16. Did he not make them one with a portion of the Spirit in their union? And what was the one God seeking? Godly offspring. So guard yourself in your spirit, and let none of you be faithless to the wife of your youth. For the man who does not love his wife, but divorces her, says the Lord, the God of Israel, covers his garment with vomit. Guard yourself in your spirit. Do not be faithless. God does not want divorce.
Dieu n'aime pas le divorce.
So you must work at your marriage.
Donc nous devons entretenir nos mariages.
And I said there are signs.
Et il y a aussi des signes.
Number one.
Et premièrement,
non-communication.
Manque de communication.
Communication in the oxygen pipe of the marriage.
Et l'autre fois, je disais que la communication, c'est l'oxygène.
If you refuse to talk to your wife, refuse to talk to your husband, and because you are angry, or she's angry all the time, you will kill your marriage. Because it's like you are blocking the doors of that marriage. It will suffocate.
Donc si à cause des problèmes, tu ne parles pas avec ton partenaire, tu vas tuer ton mariage. Parce que la communication, c'est l'oxygène de la relation.
And in the talk in the house, be careful how you use words.
Et nous devons faire beaucoup attention aux mots que nous utilisons aussi.
So, women who use all kinds of words on their husband, you must know you are allowing the foxes to destroy the marriage. And men who insult their wife rough must be careful, because you can destroy your marriage.
Et nous devons savoir aussi que les insultes ravagent nos mariages.
There are words we don't tell a woman.
Il y a des mots que nous ne pouvons jamais utiliser contre nos partenaires.
I regret that I have married you.
Par exemple, je regrette de t'avoir marié.
Where were you looking before you go and propose to her?
Où est-ce que tu regardais quand tu es parti lui dire, oh ma sœur, je t'aime?
When your chemistries and then the feces were running into your bodies and you quickly went, I want to marry you. I pray that God will revive.
C'est ma prière que Dieu va ranimer nos foyers.
Alléluia.
Amen.
When you fail to listen to your wife, you fail to listen to your husband, you will soon get to the red light.
Quand tu ignores les plaintes de ta femme ou bien de ton mari, le feu rouge va s'allumer.
You must know verbal, non-verbal, and visual communications that are taking place.
Il y a la communication verbale, il y a la communication visuelle.
You must pay attention to all that.
Et nous devons faire attention.
When the family altar is broken, it's a sign that the red light is soon coming. When you are married, you are in a relationship, and from Monday until Sunday when you meet at church, you never have 30 minutes or even 5 minutes to pray together and ask, is everything okay with you, my wife, my husband? If you never do that, know that red light is soon coming.
Et en tant que couple, si vous n'arrivez pas à prier ensemble, cela veut dire que le feu rouge va s'allumer bientôt.
So Paul has instructed the marriage people. Donc, that the man you are expected to be the pastor in that house, washing your wife with the word of God. If you are a man, you fail, you marry, and you fail to wash your wife with the word of God, you allow her to grow and become rotten, and then you begin to complain, you are the cause of that marriage.
Donc, Paul disait que les hommes doivent être les pères spirituels.
You are the cause.
De leur foyer.
You are
si tu laisses ta femme, tu ne pries pas, tu n'étudies pas la Bible avec elle et quelque chose arrive, c'est ta faute. Que le Seigneur ait pitié de nous.
Wash him with the washing. Make sure there's no sprinkle or spot in her life. Love her.
Et vous devez aimer vos femmes.
And if you are a woman that your husband failed to do this thing and you don't care about it, you think, oh, yeah, no problem, we have time now. They give you money, right? They give you material things, dresses, and you are happy. And you do not care about your spiritual life, your devotion in that house, very soon the red light will come.
Et si tu as une femme aussi et ton mari ne prie pas avec toi, il ne lit pas la Bible avec toi et ça ne te dit rien parce que il te donne de l'argent, il te fait des choses matérielles. Faut t'assurer que le feu rouge va s'allumer bientôt.
Solomon does not want to get to that point. He said, catch for us the little foxes.
Donc Solomon disait, prenez-nous les renards.
How do you relate to your wife? How do you relate to your husband?
Quelle est la relation entre toi et ta femme? Ou bien
how
toi
is
et
your
ton mari?
Family devotion?
Comment est votre
many people get a very early
dévotion familiale.
Only to return very late.
Il y a certains
sometimes you do not even know what your wife is going through. Emotionally and physically, the stress the women go through, you don't know.
Il y a certains hommes qui quittent la maison très tôt le matin et reviennent. Tard le soir, sans savoir.
Not only do they neglect communication, but they also neglect sex.
Ils négligent la communication et négligent aussi la vie sexuelle.
So the woman will stay in frustrated.
Donc quand la femme est frustrée.
Trouble in the mind emotionally, work and return and frustrated. It wants some release.
Emotionnellement.
And when they come back, they will come with all the sweats.
Et donc quand le monsieur revient à la maison,
with dirty armpits,
il transpire avec ses aisselles qui sent comme de l'oignon.
With fingernails like that of Okuku Seku.
Et les ongles des doigts sales.
And sometimes. For those with with a beard, sometimes you leave it and then if you are not very careful, it can even push the woman away.
Et ceux qui ont les barbes, ils laissent ça.
Very soon you will have a red light.
Ça ne fera pas longtemps, le feu rouge va s'allumer.
When there is a lack of sex in the marriage.
Manque de cesse dans le mariage.
There's a sign the red light is soon coming.
C'est le feu rouge va s'allumer.
There are women who use sex also as a punishment. Because he has not given me money. We shall see. We shall see what? You are only calling for red light for yourself.
Et il y a des femmes aussi qui n'aiment pas faire l'amour avec leur mari parce que l'homme ne l'avait pas donné de l'argent. Ça vous apporte, ça va vous apporter des problèmes.
Whether there is money or there's no money, your body belongs to.
Tu dois savoir que ton corps appartient à ton partenaire.
Give it to him.
S'il te donne de l'argent,
let him be satisfied. And give it to her. Other than that, you are calling for red light. Very soon, he will go outside there. And the dangerous aspect for the women is this one. When you are a man in this marriage, you lack communicating with your wife. And the communication, I'm not talking about just verbal. You see, the way you dress up, the way you carry yourself, everything about you communicates to a woman.
Quand il y a manque de la communication dans le foyer, ça apporte du feu rouge. Et tout ce que tu fais, ton apparence, ça communique aussi à la femme.
If your wife is a tired and life beauty, hello.
Et si ta femme
aime la beauté, and every time, it is not that you cannot do it all. Sometimes there are men, even when the women buy them shirts, they don't wear it.
Si la femme aime l'élégance,
and even the way they will put the shirt on, it will annoy you.
Même si la femme l'achète une chemise, il ne va pas porter.
Même la façon dont il va porter, ça va t'énerver. Sometimes the shirt will come out from the trouser and then it's like oh, the Lord have mercy upon us. All these things are part of communication in the marriage. You must watch it.
Toutes ces choses, c'est un moyen de communiquer dans le mariage.
How you treat your teeth. Every year, at least spend some money. Spend small money. Go to the dentist. Let them clean your teeth.
Même ta bouche, tu dois prendre soin.
So that when you want to go closer to her, she should be ready and open the mouth very wide for you. If you are coming and putting the head back, then you must watch your mouth, your breath.
Au cas où tu veux, je sais pas.
L'approcher, caresser.
La femme ne va pas courir.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Do not wait until there is a red light in your family. Blackness, there is no smoke, or there is no fire without smoke. The smoke will come, it will come. Quench it before it becomes fire.
Nous devons éviter tous ces problèmes dans nos mariages.
Appreciation. There are men who never appreciate their wife. They will cook for you.
Qui n'apprécient jamais leur femme.
And all your bad odor and your sweat, you go to her, and she will clean the house. She'll bath your children. And sometimes they buy socks and then singlet to you on top.
Elle fait la cuisine. Elle t'achète de petits cadeaux. Mais tu n'apprécies jamais.
And some primitive one would dare say that I have paid the dowry. And you pay what?
Et il y a certains qui exagèrent même et ils disent ah mais
j'ai payé la dot.
Mama,
I have married you.
Donc si tu fais ça, c'est pas un problème.
And that thing that you do, it's just some symbol, a token symbol. It does not make you own the woman or something. So you must respect, you must appreciate her. Thank you for accepting me.
Tu dois aussi apprécier.
Thank you for this food. I really enjoy it today.
Quand elle te fait la cuisine, tu dois la cuisine.
Thank you the way you are caring for the children. Oh, the way sometimes you support even for her to pay the bill. I'm really grateful to you. When you speak to a woman like that, she will go and carry the whole.
Si
to go to her family and bring money and give you.
Ta femme, dans tout ce qu'elle fait, elle peut même aller dans sa famille et t'apporter les biens, les biens de la famille.
You will not wake up before she come and bring your tea at your table.
Mais au lit, elle va t'apporter ton petit déjeuner.
So don't wait until there's a red light.
Faut pas attendre jusqu'à ce que le feu rouge s'allume.
Hallelujah. Amen. Appreciate him. Apologize, please. I'm sorry, as if I am a man alone. Did I tell you my story?
No.
Yes. Good. When I was going to marry my beautiful wife, there was this elder then at the PIWC who was counseling us. The counseling session was supposed to take 1 hour.
Avant mon mariage, il y avait un ancien qui nous conseillait et le conseil durait
1 hour. When we have arrived, he took the Bible and said, "Open Ephesians chapter 5. We shall read it from verse 22 to 32. I said, "Correct, elder."
Et un jour, on était parti et cet ancien a pris la Bible et il a mentionné Ephésiens
5, 22 à 32. Then he started. Wife, submit to your own husband.
Il a commencé, femme, soumets à ton mari.
Then he turned to my wife.
Et il s'est tourné vers ma femme.
Juanita, the Bible says you have to submit.
Juanita, tu dois te soumettre à ton mari.
Because Elder Dieudonné is the head in this relationship.
Parce que ton mari est le chef.
Do you hear me?
Est-ce que tu m'entends?
Quietly, she said yes, Elder.
Et ma femme a dit oui.
And for the next 45 minutes.
Et les 45 minutes restantes.
The man was on me.
Et ce monsieur.
The man was on me.
C'est comme il s'est préparé pour moi seul.
Ah, everything he said to is reading it from there.
Et il lisait les choses dans la Bible.
He got to a point I was getting angry. I said, "This counsel we have come, is it only for me?"
Je disais, ah, ce monsieur vient, il a quelque chose contre moi.
Then when he realized that, then he himself said, "Elder, I can see what is in your mind."
Je vois ce que tu penses.
You are thinking that I'm on you, eh?
Tu penses que je suis contre toi, hein?
This whole thing called marriage is dependent on you.
Et il me disait que ce mariage, le succès de ce mariage dépend de toi.
You are supposed to be the man there.
Et tu es le chef.
This woman is going to be given to you as a gift.
Et
God wants you to reshape her.
La femme, c'est un don.
God wants you to wash her.
Venant de Dieu.
God wants you to retrain her.
Donc Dieu veut que tu
God wants you to provide for her.
Agrandir dans le Seigneur.
When I got home, I said, "Wow, this
et
is marriage."
Quand je me suis rentré, j'ai dit, "Hey."
Then I knew what was ahead of me.
Et donc j'ai su que le mariage c'est pas quelque chose de blague.
So if you are a man, you are married, understand your responsibility. God giving responsibility. Woman is given to you as a helpmate. She is not to be the carrier of all the burden in the marriage. You are expected to be the head over there.
Les hommes doivent comprendre que les femmes sont seulement des supports.
The destiny of the marriage that you are guiding, you are the pilot in that marriage.
Et le succès du mariage dépend de l'homme.
And if you do your part very well, God will come in and do the rest.
Donc tu dois l'entretenir très bien.
Many Christian marriage, if you enter properly, right? If you enter properly through counselor, you enter and you apply the biblical principle, I tell you, at least your marriage will never collapse.
Amen. Amen. Donc si tu appliques tous les principes bibliques du mariage, je pense que ton mariage aura du succès.
Sometimes there are past heads or roots. That's why I say marriage doesn't happen. You must work at it. Before you marry that woman, before you marry that man, he had already gone through some nasty things in the past.
Avant de rencontrer ton partenaire, tu dois savoir que il a traversé beaucoup de choses dans le passé.
There are men who have been sexually abused by women. Mm-hmm.
Et y a des hommes qui sont abusés par les femmes.
The women are getting angry at me. It is not only women who are sexually abused by men. There are women also who abuse men.
C'est pas seulement les femmes qui sont violées par les hommes. Parfois aussi les hommes sont violés par les femmes.
So the woman or the man might have gone through some challenging time in the infancy, in her youthful time. Might have gone through some challenges. It can be spiritual, it can be physical, it can be emotional. Those things become a hateful memory in her mind. So when it comes into the marriage, you must be careful how you handle her, how you handle him.
Et parfois, les gens ont des passés douloureux. Donc, nous devons faire attention
dans
nos mariages.
Don't blame him.
Nous ne devons pas la blâmer.
Never call your wife a prostitute.
Faut jamais appeler ta femme une prostituée.
Never call your husband a foolish man.
Faut pas appeler ton mari stupide.
Those two words should never come out from your mouth.
Faut jamais utiliser ces deux mots.
Because you went to take him.
Parce que c'est toi qui es parti la prendre.
You have accepted his proposal.
Et toi aussi tu l'as accepté.
So you must work at it.
Donc vous devez entretenir vos relations afin qu'il y ait la paix.
There are people who have been raped by their own brothers, their uncle, their house, their state. They have been frustrated during their youthful day. Now they grow in that into marriage. So if you are not very careful, you don't, as a man, you really do not demonstrate love to such a person.
Il y a des femmes ou bien des gens qui sont violés par leur propre membre de la famille et ils rentrent dans le mariage avec ces douleurs.
So you must relate with them with love.
Donc, toi qui es le partenaire, tu dois démontrer.
Let them know that even though you are like that, I still love you. God will do it. It has changed. There will be revival. Oh, hallelujah.
Tu dois démontrer ton amour envers la personne, peu importe son passé.
If in the marriage relationship you keep on talking about the past of the woman, you're talking about the past of the man, you are not helping that marriage to stay.
Il ne faut jamais parler du passé de ton partenaire dans le mariage.
If a man has gone through a terrible time before in marriage, maybe he proposed to a lady who said, I will not marry you, and you are aware about that, and she has married you, and want to her. That is why the other lady didn't marry you. I told you.
Par exemple, ton partenaire a voulu marier une fille et la fille a refusé avant toi. Il ne faut jamais le rappeler de ce passé douloureux.
You must let your word be seasoned with salt.
Tes paroles doivent être aimables.
So close every past sexual door. Close the doors.
Et vous devez fermer les portes du passé.
Confess all those past, wicked past. Confess it to the Lord.
Et tu dois confesser ça à Dieu.
And ask him to take control.
Et il va prendre contrôle.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And be very careful how you bring extended families into your marriage.
Amen.
Extended family, especially African. Your sister, your brother, your aunties. There are people who respect their brothers, their sisters more than their wife and than their husband.
Nous ne devons pas laisser nos familles s'infiltrer dans nos mariages. Il y a certains hommes qui respectent leur soeur plus que leur femme.
When you do that, very soon the red light comes.
En faisant cela, le feu rouge peut s'allumer. Tu auras des problèmes.
I pray this morning that
ma prière ce matin est que
every anything that those foxes are eating in your relationship, the Lord Himself will take them out.
Amen. Que Dieu va enlever ces petits renards dans vos vies.
Because marriage will lead us to heaven or to hell, may we work on our marriages.
Amen. Parce que le mariage peut nous amener au ciel ou bien en enfer.
And this morning,
donc ce matin,
if there is any challenge in your relationship,
s'il y a un défi dans ta relation ou bien dans ton foyer,
it is not too late.
C'est pas trop tard.
Yesterday is gone.
Le passé.
Today is another day.
Et aujourd'hui c'est un autre jour.
You can begin afresh.
Vous pouvez recommencer.
You can forgive one another.
Vous pouvez vous pardonner.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
You can forgive one another.
Vous pouvez vous pardonner.
You can begin again.
Et recommencer à nouveau.
Tell your wife, may God help us catch the foxes.
Dis à ton partenaire que le Seigneur nous aide à attraper.
Get closer to your husband and say, I'm sorry for all the pain I caused you. Get closer to your wife and say, ah, honey, I'm sorry for all the pain I caused you.
Tenez, et tu lui dis, je suis désolé pour les troubles et les douleurs que je t'ai causé.
All the mistakes that you have committed yourself, which you know, be open and say, ah, honey, I'm very sorry. Just forgive me. I know it is because of my irresponsibility.
Et demande pardon à ton partenaire.
Tell him it is because I was irresponsible.
Et il faut lui dire que c'est parce que j'étais
irresponsable.
Irresponsable. Merci.
And tell him that, oh, I'm sorry, it's because you treated me this way that I was not patient.
Et toi aussi, il faut lui dire que c'est parce que tu m'as traité ainsi, c'est pour cela.
But for the sake of heaven.
Mais à cause de Dieu.
For the sake of the next generation.
À cause de la génération suivante.
Let's begin again.
Recommençons à nouveau.
You will never have married. You will never have proposed to a woman if you have not loved her. So there is love.
Si tu n'as pas de l'amour pour ton partenaire, je pense que
tu ne l'aurais pas marié. If you have not loved your husband, you wouldn't have accepted his proposal. So there is a love.
Et c'est pareil pour toi, la femme.
But you have allowed foxes.
Mais parce que vous avez laissé les petits renards.
Sit down today. Those who do not have their wife here, call them.
Et ceux qui sont mariés, mais leurs femmes sont au pays.
Make deep reflection and say, I'm sorry. Après ce mensonge, I'm sorry. Kojo.
Faut appeler ta femme. Et demander pardon.
We can begin afresh.
Faut lui dire, nous pouvons recommencer.
We can begin afresh. Then, if you do this, we can possess.
Et en faisant cela, nous pouvons posséder les nations.
Shall we be outstanding?